Hello everyone, this is Hira Irshad and I welcome you all in this new episode of Getting Peshawar Started. Today we have a very special guest with us, somebody who has pioneered medical sciences and healthcare in KPK. We have Shafique Ur-Rehman with us and he will tell us how this journey started.
Assalamu alaikum, thank you very much. The story of RMI begins back in 2002 and the healthcare landscape in Peshawar or KP as a whole was very different back then. When it consisted of a number of smaller private healthcare facilities and some government hospitals, but there was no concept of private healthcare as in everything under one roof where you offer all the different specialities. And this is how RMI started, initially focusing on cardiac surgery and cardiology in a single site 250 bed hospital. But over the years it has expanded horizontally and vertically, so we are now operating in two verticals, which is higher education and healthcare. And within healthcare, we offer services in more than 15 different specialities, in addition to postgraduate education as well.
So Shafique, that was the story of RMI. Tell us a little bit about yourself. Are you a doctor by profession? How did you end up in RMI?
No, interestingly enough, I'm not a medical doctor myself. I was never interested in medical MBBS or medical education as such. However, due to a certain turn of events, I realized at one point in time that I had to come back and I had to be a part of the organization, which is why I went off to the United Kingdom initially to pursue some business studies, and then I went to Frankfurt, Germany for a program in international healthcare and hospital management. So I completed my MBA there, and since then I'm back in RMI for about more than a decade now.
So Shafique, when you joined Rehman Medical Institute, it was run by your father initially. How important do you think a team is to run an organization of that magnitude? And as you said that, you know, initially you had issues with hiring good people. How did you overcome that challenge, specifically being in KPK?
Yeah, so that's something very interesting about the Rehman Medical Institute, as opposed to many others. My father happens to be a cardiac surgeon, a pioneer cardiac surgeon, and he's been practicing since many years, initially in the United Kingdom, then in Karachi, and now here in Peshawar as well. However, since day one, we've had a professional team managing the organization. So from day one, we've got a professional chief executive officer, followed by a few others as well. And the complete setup was professionally organized. Of course, the vision and the direction is by the chairman himself, but the organization has been led by professionals. Over the years, there's been a lot of challenges. So there was a big patch for a number of years due to the law and order situation, when it was very difficult to attract and retain good talent in Peshawar. It was in those challenging years that we had a lot of difficulty, but I think over a period of time, RMI has set a reputation for itself and we are able to attract and retain good talent lately.
So you guys have been bringing new concepts to Peshawar. Now we're catching the fourth industrial revolution and one of the verticals is genomic sciences and synthetic biology. Please tell me if RMI is doing something innovative in the healthcare sector.
So innovation has been ingrained in the RMI philosophy right from the beginning. The whole concept of a large private hospital in a city like Peshawar back in 2002 was innovative, very ambitious to say, but I'm glad, by the grace of God, it has been a concept that has proven itself, and there are others who are now trying to emulate the model as well. So over the years as well, we've realized that status quo is not an option. We cannot lie down in our comfort zone thinking that we're doing everything that needs to be done. We have to be on the lookout for new cutting edge services for which there's a demand globally and locally. So genomic sciences, and which is a part of personalized medicine, is a very exciting area that we are exploring, and we've taken some early steps in this direction. The first next gen sequencer in Pakistan has been installed in RMI and has been operational for quite some time now. In layman or simplified terms, every human being, the genomic makeup of every human being is unique, and so should the treatments. This is largely the concept of personalized medicine, and this is what we are exploring. We have done a number of research projects in this area, and we are looking for ways and means to operationalize the curative side of medicine as well. We are using it for diagnostic purposes right now, but a lot of it is research based even now. Digital health, artificial intelligence, machine learning, these are the new buzzwords that we see globally. Automation or digitization has done wonders in different sectors. It's done wonders in aviation. We take it for granted in banking. You know, you can take out your ATM or a credit card and you might go to the North Pole or Alaska and you have access to your bank accounts there. but you don't have access to your health records if you move from one place to another. So EMR, HMIS, these are promising areas that we're working on right now. We have implemented different technologies for a number of years now, but I think it's about time we leverage what modern cloud computing, artificial intelligence, machine learning, big data has to offer. We've taken some early steps in this direction, and I think it's very innovative in the healthcare landscape of Pakistan. So we're working with a few partner companies, very early stages, but going forward, we are hoping to have a complete digitization of all our clinical health records. And using the same, we want to tap into cutting edge technologies such as AI to give us good predictive models on how to make the best choices for patients. So a typical example for this might be each time a patient undergoes a certain diagnostic investigation. In cardiology, that might be an angiogram, it might be a certain laboratory investigation or a radiology investigation. A clinician uses their expertise and knowledge and all the available data in front of them to make the best possible recommendations on what might be best for the patient. However, there's a growing wave of information globally, which points us into a direction whereby such decisions can be much better guided using tools such as artificial intelligence to look at the unique circumstances of that patient and rely on a lot of evidence that is now digitized to make much better predictions on what might be suitable for the patient and lead to much better outcomes. Having said that, I have to say the role of the clinician will definitely not eliminate or even diminish. The role will just change. So whereas typically a clinician is relying on their own memory, on what the patient is telling them right there, utilizing these technologies, utilizing access to data on a very real-time basis will help them make decisions which will significantly improve the outcomes for those patients. It is holding a lot of promise in other areas as well. So imaging is another area where we see growing evidence of there being a substantial impact. So histopathology is another major example, or radiology imaging for that matter. So typically you've got all these images which have been digitized for a long time, and a clinician using nothing more than the naked eye and their own knowledge in the sphere is making certain decisions or recommendations. Modern imaging techniques and again AI has had some promising early results in this area as well. Those inputs from these technologies will significantly inform a consultant's decision or a physician's decision, leading to much better health outcomes. Hopefully, I think later this year or early next year, we will have some very good examples to demonstrate effectiveness of the same.
So apart from the work that you do, we also know that you mentor young entrepreneurs now. What has that experience given you?
So my participation with the NIC Peshawar and a few other initiatives has been somewhat recent, but I'm still very excited by the potential it holds, and by interaction with all these young budding entrepreneurs is very interesting, it's very enlightening. It's a rewarding experience personally as well. Learning about all these initiatives that they're taking, learning about their approach to solving problems and taking a different view of things is very interesting, and I think it holds a lot of promise for the long term. I see a very bright future for the entrepreneurial community and the ecosystem in KP as a whole, and I'm looking forward to some of them turning into products and services that all of us will be familiar with.
So you've met quite a few startup founders. What do you think are their strengths, or where do you think they're lacking? Is it in the totality of the problem that they look into, or what is it?
I've had the chance to interact with a few of the young founders that are working here. Some of them are relevant to the healthcare sphere. I think the approach is right. They are investing in themselves, in their skill sets, which is so important for it to be a sustainable and a viable proposition in the long term. The need is very much there. They're very clear about a problem that they're trying to solve. I think going forward, they just need to be more in tune with the ground realities. It's okay to be ambitious. You know, at times they're very forward-looking and ambitious, which is fine, but it has to be grounded in reality as well. But I think it's a learning curve. They're getting the right kind of training and exposure over here. And going forward, I think many of them will prosper, and I look forward to seeing them get big.
So Shafique, there was a wave of startups who were working on different applications, mobile applications and web applications. Now different other areas emerging such as AI and machine learning. What kind of startups would you like to see in the healthcare sector? What do you think that, you know, young entrepreneurs should work on?
So I think there are a couple of areas where the young entrepreneurs can invest in, they could explore. The first would be in terms of equipment or different tools and gadgets. So within biomedical engineering, there are lots of tools that are available globally, but we realize that they're not feasible for a local market for one reason or another. Usually economic limitations or financial limitations are a major reason for the same. There's a great possibility of replicating the same and using local innovation, coming up with solutions which are economically feasible and viable for the local market as well. I think the next big area would be digital health. So, for example, organizations such as us, we would always have a long priority list. There'll be areas we'll be focusing on, and that will be part of our long-term roadmap. But that still leaves a lot of niche areas where we might not be focusing, but we would definitely welcome other players to come into it and tap into the resources that we have to come up with solutions that would benefit patients as part of our community. So using AI and going into all the data that we are capturing, all the solutions that we already have, and taking it to the next level to focus on very special services or unique services is something we would welcome and encourage. This has been done globally in many areas, and there's a great need for our young entrepreneurs and startups to come in and look into these things as well. So mobile apps would be the other logical direction to go into. Increasingly, people do not want to avail healthcare in the way that they used to many years ago. For different laboratory investigations, people, if they can get the service done at home, they really wouldn't want to go into a hospital or laboratory for that matter. Wearables is changing the healthcare landscape in a big way as well. There is access to a lot more data. There are devices which tell you exactly how much sleep you're getting, how much exercise you're getting, what are the calories that you're burning. All important data for your caregivers or your physicians to make much better informed decisions. We personally are not doing much about it in the near future, but in the long-term roadmap, if there are startups who have a keen interest in these or other technologies, I think we'd welcome them, and so would all the other healthcare providers that exist out there.
Shafique, is there anything specific and advice that you would like to give to these aspiring entrepreneurs or entrepreneurs who want to do something in healthcare?
A couple of things, in fact. The first, I would say it is very important to be specialized, to focus on a particular problem. It's good enough to say I intend to solve a number of problems, I want to be the next Google or I want to be the next Uber, all that is fine. But initially they need to have a very narrow focus. Going global is great, but you need to resolve some local problems first. You need to have a proof of concept before you can replicate the model elsewhere or scale it up. That is the first. Second, I would say, is domain knowledge is critical. Knowing that there's a problem in healthcare is one thing, but going into it or tapping into resources who are fully aware of the detailed problem, that is absolutely critical. It has to be viable, it has to be feasible. Right here in Peshawar, it's a different thing to say there's a big market for it in North America and Europe elsewhere, but it has to work out here for it to be successful before you can think of replicating the same. So I think good domain knowledge, a model that is scalable, it is feasible, it has to be grounded in you know, the ground realities. Focusing on one problem is so important. I've interacted with a number of different startups who are trying to do too much. You know, it's a great spirit to have. It's a great motivation as well. But taking things one step at a time, prioritizing what you want to do, having a very clear roadmap on where you want to be a year or 2 years from now, and be the very best at what you do. I think that's absolutely critical.
Thank you very much, Shafique, for giving us your time, for being with us here on Getting Peshawar Started. We are really glad that we have people like Shafique who are now part of the entrepreneurial ecosystem. We're really glad that they give us time and they take time out for startups to mentor them and to nurture them. So we hope that with people like Shafique, we will be able to grow this ecosystem more. Thank you very much.